Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and I've got some more MLB 14 The Show action for you today. I'm starting another series before the game was even released, and when I was hearing information about the new things added to the game, one of the things that caught my attention was the fact that you can now player lock major league players, existing players, during your franchise mode or your season mode and control them as if it was like a Road to the Show setup. And when I heard that, I had the idea of doing a player lock series with a player that I wanted to spotlight in Major League Baseball. Now, I had something in mind that I thought was really appropriate for this season. I know it was suggested by one or two of you in comments before, whether it was live streams or videos, but I had a couple suggestions to do Derek Jeter on his final ride, the final season in Major League Baseball for the captain. What a career it's been for Derek Jeter, 3,300 plus hits coming into this season. Obviously coming off of major injury that derailed last season, but he wants to go out with a healthy one here. So I'm selecting Derek Jeter and player locking him down here in season mode for the Yankees. So we're going to follow the path of the final season for Derek Jeter here in MLB 14 The Show, and I guess we'll compare it to see how it goes in real life for Jeter, as opposed to me playing this out. So it might be kind of fun. So I put it in season mode since we are only going to do this 1 year. It's his final season after all. So looking at the career stats, 3,316 hits, 256 homers, 1,261 RBIs, and a 312 lifetime average, 18 major league seasons. My goodness, just a shade over 18. And he is 39 years old. What a career it's been for Derek Jeter. And I'll be the first to admit, I'm not a Yankees fan. As a matter of fact, I'm quite the opposite. I'm a diehard Red Sox fan and a Twins fan here because I live in the Twin Cities here, but always have been a Red Sox fan. But I tell you, it is hard not to admire and look at the career that Derek Jeter's had and not be in amazement of what he's accomplished. So, I mean, that is not going to hold back anything with me doing this series. I want to honor him this way in highlighting him on the channel here. So Derek Jeter it is, and we're going to go ahead and jump into the very first spring training game. I assure you this will be the first and last spring training game covered in this series, but I just kind of wanted to get our feet wet here and get a look at what we're dealing with the new player lock system. So you'll see it plays out a lot like Road to the Show. You'll get your player who you've locked up. You'll get their at-bats. You'll get their fielding chances. And it's a very much condensed game that way, just as it would be in Road to the Show. But obviously you get to use established major leaguers. You don't have to power them up. You don't have to worry about what kind of points they're earning. So it's a little different in that aspect. As you see a double play ball barehanded by Jeter, he pauses and then throws to second to complete the double play. Nice play to barehand that. Let's watch that again as we've got a nice setup for an easy double play. And Jeter just barehands that. Nice job. All right, so there you go. Like I said, you'll see some of their fielding attempts. You saw him get a hit, and of course it's just spring training. Pittsburgh winning the game 4-1, but who cares? After all, it is spring training, so we will start to sim this whole spring training period, and my goodness, we've already lost Brett Gardner for the season with a torn MCL. Well, not the obvious choice is to put him on the 60-day DL and beyond, so, well, that's not good. We've already lost a starter for the entire year, so we'll have to see how we can go about replacing him there as we have advanced through spring training and it's time to start the regular season with a series in Houston.
Tuesday night baseball now from the home of the Astros, Minute Maid Park in Houston. It's opening night 2014 and we've got a good matchup here between the New York Yankees and the Houston Astros. I again, everybody. It's finally here. Welcome to our special opening day edition of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, as we get set to get things going, it's the pitching that has to be considered one of the strong points on this ball club.
Yeah, and pitching's going to be important for these guys. No question about it. They're only going to go as far as this group right here is going to take them. And to me, it looks like a staff that's capable of getting the job done.
The date that's been circled for weeks is finally here. It's opening night. It's the show. And it's coming up next.
Opening day or opening night festivities are in the books, and it's time for the teams to take the field now here, waiting for the Astros to jump out of their dugout here and get on out in front of their home crowd, get this season underway. It's a good crowd for the Astros. I don't think you're going to get a crowd like that outside of opening day, maybe not even on opening day. I don't know what was the actual crowd for this game when they played a week and a half ago, or whatever it was. I don't know. Well, here's our starting lineup. Why is A-Rod in there? My goodness, come on. Seriously, this is the updated roster? Ugh, that's frustrating.
Derek Jeter, the first at-bat now for Derek Jeter, and he'll get a nice ovation here from this crowd as they know he's playing his final season here in 2014.
Okay, they deliver with the little things again. They got the fact that Jeter is in his last year. That's the whole reason we're doing this series, and it was acknowledged with a tip of the cap there by the Astros fans. Very classy and very cool that it's in the game, and he gets a base hit in his first at-bat of the season, so that feels really good there, getting a base knock, trying to start things on the right foot. But back to that A-Rod thing. Oh, I don't know. This roster was the April 8th roster update. This should at least have the opening day rosters. I know it doesn't have the full minors. That's what we're waiting for with the Operation Sports Forum rosters. As you see, that bag is stolen there, thrown out in time, and we'll see a replay as he steals this one basically off Sabathia, not giving him much chance to throw him out. So as we wait for Operation Sports rosters with the full minor leagues, that's what I want to do when I do my full-blown franchise that I'll be making all the moves with. As you see, a nifty double play started there. Just do nip him at first base to complete the double play. Dexter Fowler doesn't think so, however, but he's overruled here. He is out. So nice double play. But anyway, so A-Rod being on that roster, that's a mystery. The only thing I can think of is that maybe he was buried into like AAA roster somehow. But he should be on a suspended list. He shouldn't be on there. He should be on like an injured reserve list, if nothing else, if they don't have a suspended list. I mean, maybe he got bumped back up when Gardner went out for the season on the DL. I don't know, but that's almost inexcusable that he's on there. Now I got to deal with A-Rod. I got to see if there's a way that I can get rid of him. Well, I should be able to get rid of him. I should have control of the team. I just player lock during games. So I guess that'll be the next move, is to rid my lineup of A-Rod completely. One way or another, whether I release him or if I trade him or something. I really don't want this to be much about like the franchise aspect. I want this to be about Jeter as he strikes out there in the ninth to end the game. So he just has the one hit in the opener, which was the single at the first at bat. The Yankees go down, and they go down hard, getting shut out here. And your MVP of the game is going to be Jared Cozart. He pitches a great game here with 10 strikeouts. And he had 2 walks, just 4 hits given up. That's a gem here as he gets the shutout on opening night. So the Yankees go down 5-0. This looks very similar to what happened in real life in this series. I believe, didn't the Yankees lose the first 2 of the series? If I remember correctly, I believe that's how it went down. So here we are for game 2, hoping to rebound and get a victory. But it's already 4-0 Houston in the third. That's not good. We get another chance for a double play. Turn it, baby. Yep, they got it. So Jeter starting another double play. So that gets the Yankees out of the inning, but they need to find their bats because they have not pushed home a run here in a game and a third already. And they don't even have a hit today so far. So let's see if they can change that with Jeter coming back up to the plate here, already 0-for-1, popping out in the first inning. Looking to get back in that batter's box, work a good at bat here, and get a good pitch to hit. And with an 0-1 count, he gets that pitch and drives it to left center. It is going to be over the left fielder's head, and this will be extra bases for Jeter. Oh, yeah, stay at second. He thought about going to third, or at least he was going to round it and give that impression to make him at least look that way. So Jeter in with a double. I don't really get anything out of it. It's 6-1 at this point, and he pops out in this at-bat. So that was not what they needed there. He needed to come up with something for an RBI or whatever. You can tell he's frustrated, spinning that helmet down. So he had the double earlier, but he really, well, let's just face it, he wasn't going to come up with a 5-run homer there or anything. That'd be impossible, but he was hoping just to spark his team there, as they are just not hitting here. They lose this game 6-1, and now Tanaka's hurt. Although it looks like this one is not serious. Bruised ribs, just a few days. So he should be back for his next start, I would imagine. So the Astros looking for the sweep here of the Yankees, and the Yankees want to avoid that at all costs. So this will be a big ball game here. Up 2-0 in the fifth. Runner on first, and Jeter is going to slap that to right field. It's going to fall for a base hit. Runner will stay at second, so we'll have first and second after the Jeter single. A nice job right there to get himself on base and continue what they hope is going to be more runs coming across the plate here, already up 2-0, as you see a replay there of the sharp single to right. So let's see what we've got here now. 3-0 game as he's advanced to third, and that ball is under the glove of Altuve there at second. Jeter will score on the play, and it's a 4-0 lead for the Yankees. So they're finally breaking through with some runs in this game here. It's still 4-0 in the sixth when that ball, I don't know if that hit the first base bag or what, but it hit something, and it changed course just enough to skip by the first baseman. That's going to be an infield base hit and an RBI for Derek Jeter. Hey, he could use a little luck. So could the team. So there you go. Up 5-0 now in the eighth with a runner on. 1-0 count. And he hits this fairly well, but that's a nice play. Flip to second, and they get the force out. So no further damage done for the Yankees there, but they're getting good pitching themselves today and keeping the Astros down, which you kind of would have thought they would have done all series, but no. But they do finally get one of the three games here, winning it 5-2. So a little bit of a disappointing first series, dropping 2 of 3. But that is how the season starts, and that is how our Derek Jeter player lock final season series gets underway. There'll be much more of this following Derek Jeter and comparing and contrasting to his real-life final Major League season. Come on back for more. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.